everyone, this is Dr. Salcedo, your conscious gynecologist. I'm so glad you're here. Today I'm going to be talking to you about the vaginal microbiome live from the beach. Today I'm actually giving myself a little bit of quiet time to really take care of myself and to think creatively, to think of videos to really help women. So here's our first one. We're going to be talking about the vaginal microbiome. And well, why is the vaginal microbiome so important? It really does help create a stable environment to women and women's health. And I'm going to teach you a little bit about why that is. Thanks for joining. I'm so glad you're here. The vaginal microbiome is a collection of healthy bacteria that is on the surface of our private area that involves our pubic hair, the vulva, the folds, and even some of the areas of the canal of the actual vagina. The vaginal microbiome is a collection of healthy bacteria, a little bit of fungus, and some just different proteinaceous debris that really does help prevent infection for women. So often, women are shamed about the way that their vulva smells or what the environment needs to look like, or even if there should be a lot of grooming. And really, today's video is going to help you understand what is helpful and what might not be helpful. So what I want to share with you is that the reason why it's okay for little babies and prepubescent girls to use baby wipes is because they actually haven't gone through puberty yet. And so what happens when ladies go through puberty is there is an attraction of a special kind of normal bacteria called lactobacillus. And lactobacillus is attracted to the rise in estrogen from when a young girl goes through her first period and through the pubertal time. That rise in estrogen increases a special kind of molecule called glycogen within the surface of our skin in our private area. And this glycogen attracts a special kind of normal bacteria called lactobacillus, among others. Lactobacillus, believe it or not, is nature's soap. It actually secretes a special kind of chemical called hydrogen peroxide. And this hydrogen peroxide kills off all the germs. So a lady is actually has her own self-cleaning microenvironment of army of bacteria that actually protects our private area. And so there really actually isn't a lot of cleaning using products that need to be involved when a woman takes care of her private area. Honestly, what we do recommend as gynecologists is that ladies just use water with a washcloth to clean their private area. There really isn't a whole lot of soap or sprays or products that are specially pH balanced for the vagina and the vulva. Really, just water is all you need. Oftentimes what I get is questions about whether women should shave off their pubic hair or how grooming of their pubic hair is really important or not. Honestly, that's a private issue, but if you decide to groom your pubic hair, that's totally fine. Maybe you can just do the bikini line and just leave a little bit of hair. But if you think about it, the good bacteria need to stick to something. And so the more pubic hair that you have, the more healthy your vaginal environment will be. Remember, the lactobacillus and the collection of healthy bacteria in this area actually secrete that hydrogen peroxide that will kill off a lot of the germs that cause bladder infections and yeast infections, and sometimes an odorous overgrowth of a normal bacteria called Gardnerella, or sometimes in clinical medicine, we call it bacterial vaginosis. Bacterial vaginosis is an overgrowth of normal bacterial flora or bacteria in the vaginal environment. But sometimes when it gets a little out of hand, when the lactobacillus is not able to do its job, there's an overgrowth and it sometimes causes like a yellow or a little bit of a fishy odor. So sometimes treatment is involved. But honestly, if ladies will take care of their private area using just water and a very limited soap, then that will actually create a normal bacteria and improve the balance. oftentimes when ladies are on certain birth controls, that actually reduces our estrogen levels. It will actually decrease the number of lactobacillus in our vaginal environment because of the suppression of ovulation. And that's just birth control doing its job. But sometimes it can cause ladies to have vaginitis or unusual discharge and stuff that can be really problematic for a lot of women. And so that's why sometimes birth control options that suppress ovulation can sometimes disrupt female's private area, that vaginal microenvironment. And that's okay, but sometimes it just becomes really problematic that they need to stop and use other forms of birth control. That being said, it's really great to know what our normal ebbs and flows of estrogen and progesterone are, because that really does dictate how our feminine environment is. I hope that you found this video helpful, and maybe that you'll share it with a friend one day. And if you like this channel, please subscribe, and so I can give you more content of things that might be helpful for you. Well, thank you so much, and I hope you have a great day.